एशियानी
और कुछ चैट बॉक्स ओपन कर। ओके
एशियानी शेलिपोन वंते
सरे सरे नमा
और कट ले रहा राखी
करता करता मैं क्लास है पर करता
गिफ्ट होम डेलीवरी एड्रेस
ना का
अदर होम डेलीवरी
लेदो आई लिव विथ माय ब्रदर्स ब्रदर ओनली ओके नाउ एवरीबॉडी सेफ्टी इज अ मेन गिफ्ट फॉर एवरीवन ओके అంతే ఇంకేం లేదు అన్నిటికంటే గిఫ్ట్ కంటే ఇప్పుడు కావాల్సింది
సేఫ్టీ ఫర్ యూ
నువ్వు నేను అందరు బాగుండాలి నెక్స్ట్ టైం హ్యాపీగా రాఖీ పండుగ చేసుకోవాలి ఓకేనా 37 మెంబర్స్ అదే
ఇంకా రావాలి
వాంట్ టు సే ఎనీథింగ్ యూ రైట్ ఇన్ ద చాట్ బాక్స్ విల్ స్టార్ట్ ద క్లాస్ నౌ ఇట్ ఇస్ 10:14 ఓకేనా ఈ బక్రీద్ వచ్చింది వల్లే క్రతము రాఖీ పండుగ అంటే జనాలు తగ్గిపోయారు స్టూడెంట్స్ యు కాల్ యువర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ అండ్ టెల్ దెం టు అటెండ్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యు ఓకే
నార్మల్ 60 దాటి ఉండాలి బట్ యా ఓకే మన
ఓం కే
బట్ మాక్సిమం ఫ్రెండ్స్ ఆల్్రెడీ సెట్ ఇన్ ద గ్రూప్ నో దే వోంట్ బి కమ్ టుడే
ఓకే ఓకే మన కార్తికేయన్ అనే అబ్బాయి కార్తికేయన్ అనే అబ్బాయి వచ్చాడు ఇప్పుడు హి గేవ్ వెరీ గుడ్ ఆన్సర్స్
వాళ్ళు బయటకి కార్తికే వచ్చాడు మీరు ప్రకాష్ తొందర వీళ్ళు లాకుండా ఇంటికి వద్దు డిస్టర్బ్ చేయదు
ఓకే విల్ స్టార్ట్ ది క్లాస్ నౌ సీ హియర్ నౌ వి ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు ఎండ్ అప్ ది అటామిక్ స్ట్రక్చర్ ఇన్ అటామిక్ స్ట్రక్చర్ దట్ ఈస్ సింపుల్ నథింగ్ ఇస్ దేర్ ఎక్స్ట్రా థింగ్ వి ఆల్రెడీ డిస్కస్డ్ దట్ ఈస్ special electronic configuration special electronic configuration special electronic configuration of few elements so we'll see what are these few elements that is for our syllabus we have two elements that is chromium the second one is copper everyone knows the atomic number of chromium is 24 and the copper is 29 and you must all have studied in your 10th okay so and I stressfully I explained there when you write electronic configuration the 3d must be written before the 4s the same question given in a previous paper Saturday paper if you observe some titanium or something element electronic configuration was asked okay 3d3 4s2 something like that okay titanium vanadium something was asked so see here how to write the electronic configuration of chromium just we have to follow the rules to write electronic configuration I'll say once again electronic configuration means electronic regarding electrons configuration means arrangement configuration means arrangement the proper arrangement so how you arrange them in increasing order of their energies in increasing nothing written on the top I'm writing here only. Okay, nothing written on the top. So from here only, ma. So how to write electronic configuration? The energies of electrons to be decided. How you calculate or decide the energy of a electron? Auber principle. Auber principle as a formula. What is that? N plus L. Yes. Principal quantum number plus azimuthal quantum number. Everyone knows N plus L. N is principal quantum number in which orbit the electron is present. Azimuthal quantum number in which sublevel, suborbit or subshell electron is present. The sum of these two is known as N plus L, energy of electron. And I told that wherever you find electron, listen all of you, wherever you find electron, wherever you catch the electron around the nucleus in 3D space, that 3D space is called orbital. Who is this D. Mahesh? Please concentrate me. Listen. So, wherever you catch the electron around the nucleus, the 3D space around the nucleus, that 3D space is called orbital. Okay? The electron will not be living like us in a home. It is just imaginary space around the positive charge. Because electron is being a negative charge, this negative charged particle, invisible particle, revolves around the positive charge. What is positive charge? Nucleus. Because it is composed of positive protons. P for positive, P for protons. And everyone knows the all the mass of the atom means atomic mass, protons plus neutrons are present at the center of the atom, which is called nucleus. So nucleus is positive because it is composed of positive protons and neutral neutrons. And around this spherical positive nucleus, positive charge, electron cloud, electrons are moving with certain velocity at certain distance, that is radius of orbit, with certain energy, energy of electron. Energy of electron according to Bohr's theory, Bohr's atomic model or Bohr's theory. What is that? Energy of orbit. Now next level, little more, according to Sommerfeld, that is quantum numbers. The energy of electron is not only of orbit, it is some additional energy, that is sublevel energy only. And based on this only, Arnold Sommerfeld, who proposed azimuthal quantum number, he explained that the electron which is present in the given orbit may be present in different sublevels. Therefore, the one spectral line, simple spectral line, single line, split into doublet or triplet, which is known as fine spectrum. So fine spectrum is explained by Arnold Sommerfeld, which is known as azimuthal quantum number. Okay, we know that the principal quantum number or Bohr's theory only can explain line spectrum, but could not explain fine spectrum. The fine spectrum are two, Zeeman and Stark, which is not explained. You just go back the Bohr's theory. Okay, Bohr's theory, demerits, and just revise the quantum numbers. I hope next week will be what cumulative exam will may be there. Some additional questions will be there, 25%. Okay, ma? Because unit is completed. So finally, now everyone knows what? Wherever you find electron around the nucleus, that 3D space is called orbital. And orbital energy is same as energy of electron. and which is given as n plus l. And this n plus l rule only called as a work principle. A work principle. Now listen, all of you. I told in the previous class. Now we are going to start for this week periodic table. In periodic table, you learn modern periodic table. Okay, modern periodic table or long form of a periodic table. We have syllabus up to that for this week. So how they are arranged in modern periodic table? The elements are arranged in increasing order of their atomic number. So atomic number means we generally think number of electrons, but what I told that number of electrons are equal to number of protons which are present in nucleus. The protons are being positive, protons are being positive, atomic number is number of protons. So if you take any atomic number of any element, what do you see there? The atomic numbers are positive numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like that. When you complete the periodic table, it will contain how many elements? 118 elements. And all the elements have atomic number just 118, positive number. But nowhere you find -1, -2 atomic number. So keep in mind, atomic number is a positive number and it is number of protons. Since atom is neutral, the atoms are neutral. See, I have written here chromium. Did I wrote any charge on this chromium? Okay, on the copper, did I wrote any charge? Nothing. Charge is nothing means the atom element is neutral. Why? Because in the nucleus, it will have certain number of positive protons, and out of the nucleus the same number of equal number of electrons with a negative charge revolves. So atom is neutral. So once now all we have to clap, okay, hats off to the person who gave the idea, the great idea, two ideas that thought that who gave the atom is spherical and the atom is electrically neutral. Who is that person? Great scientist, very olden scientist, who gave the first atomic model? Thomson, J.J. Thomson, who gave the idea that atom is spherical and explains only electrical neutrality. Atom is neutral. Okay, J.J. Thomson. So now this is what we have learned. Now we are going to write electronic configuration of chromium. I have written here special. Special means it is not normal. Means which is abnormal. Something teda. Edo teda kottindi ikkada. So we'll see what is that difference. So how you write 1s2 as madam told, 1 plus for s 0, 1 energy. 1 plus 0 is 1. Then 2s2. Because S itself is orbital, S is itself is sublevel, and which can have only 2 electrons. After this, 2P, which can have 6 electrons. P sublevel can have 6 electrons, but any P orbital, any P orbital can have any 2 electrons. Wherever you listen word orbital, the number of electrons, how many? 2 only. So 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. How many? 10. 10 out of 24. How many left? 14. So next is 3s2. Once again, same. S can have only 2 electrons. Next, after this, 3p6. What is this one? 2 plus 2, 4 plus 6, 10. 10 plus this 8, 18. So for this, I can write instead of this, what is that? Condensed. Why writing all the time this large electronic configuration? 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6 is what? 18. 18 electrons. 18 electrons means it is argon element. Condensed means you are shortening the electronic configuration. It is called condensed electronic configuration. Whenever you use inert gas config, inert gas symbols, it is called condensed electronic configuration. Because you are going to learn 2 years. 2 years. So many groups you are going to learn. So when you write electronic configuration for many elements, you have to use condensed electronic configuration. Okay. Now, after 18, 24 minus 18, how many left? 24 minus 18, how many? 6. I have to put 6 electrons. So, after this, see here, all of you. Please, but all of you see here. Two people gave this answer, Puneet Reddy, everyone. 4s1, 3d5. I explained in previous class also. 3d5 must be written first. After 4s. And the same question, same like question is given in question paper also. Please you check all that question paper, all of you. See here, all of you. See, this is, I'm writing here, this is black is nucleus. Around this, I'm writing this blue line. I have written this blue line. N equal to 1, first orbit, which can have only 2 electrons. And after this, black line, which is second orbit, which can have only 8 electrons. And after that, I have taken this one more blue line, which is N equal to 3. N equal to 3, in which you can have how many electrons? 18 electrons. Very good. 18 electrons. So, N equal to 1, 2 electron means only 1 is 2. And 8 means 2 is 2, 2p6. Remember, in second orbit, you could not find a D sublevel. Why? Always L is azimuthal quantum number value. L is sublevels. And L value should be less than the principal quantum number. So when n equal to 3, L must be less than the n. So n equal to 3 means what is the value maximum for the L? 2 only. Okay, 2. So what is that? What do you get here? Sorry, n number. What is this? Number of sublevels will be what it is? N values will be there, but L value must be less. So S, L equal to 0, P, L equal to 1, D, L equal to 2. So in N equal to 2, L equal to 2 is impossible. Therefore, 2D orbital is impossible. I have told so many times it is. L equal to 2 means D sublevel. And L should be always less than the N. So therefore, 2D is impossible. So therefore, in second orbit, you have 2S and 2P. But you won't get 2D. Okay. And in third, N equal to 3. 3S, 2. 3P, 6 possible. And 3D. So tell me where the 3D is present? Third orbit. So when you come from nucleus to outside, you say first hello to 1s. Seconds, in second shell, 2s, 2p. And when you come to third shell, you meet with 3s, 3p and 3d. When you come to the fourth orbit, then you say hello to fourth shell. What is that? 4s, 4p, 4d, 4f. Now tell me, where do you find this? 3D in third orbit. And where you find 4S? Fourth orbit. So 3D is in third orbit close to nucleus. 4S is fourth orbit away from the nucleus. So while writing electronic configuration, please see here all of you. See all of you. What is this? Argon is 18. After this, you're going to fill 6 electrons. Though you fill 4 is first. Why? Because for 4 is n equal to 4. S l equal to 0. Its energy is 4. Because of low n plus l, it is filled first. 4 is 2. And how many left to 4? 3d4. There is all conquer. This is 3d4. We expect. But what happens here? 4s is low energy. But 3d is what? 3 plus 2, 5. So without completely filling, of 4s, the one electron goes into 3d. So therefore, what we write? 3d5 and 4s1. 3d5, 4s1. So here, what is the rule broken? Aufbau principle is broken. Okay. Aufbau principle is broken or violated. Without completely filling the low energy 4s, the electron is shifted to high energy 3d to get extra stability. As I told in the previous class, we have to follow traffic rules for everyone's safety. But sometimes you can break the rules. Suppose emergency is there. In the same way, along with the above, we have Hund's rule. According to Hund's rule, someone gave answer here, Hund's rule. Shrikar. Okay. So according to Hund's rule, what is that? This element, chromium. All right, now, argon, which is 3d5 and 4s1. Though 4s is incompletely filled, though it is low energy, 3d5, high energy, but electron is more here. Because why? According to Hund's rule, now see, this is a d sublevel, which is having the 5 orbitals. And all the orbitals have same energy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So when you fill each orbital, for all of them, energy is same. Energy of orbital is n plus l. So what is the n plus l value? N equal to 3. For d, l equal to 2. That is, all are having what? 5. N plus l is 5. So when you fill d generated orbitals, each one with one electron, which are spinning in same direction. You can put upwards or you can put all the downwards. Okay. So I have filled the, all the orbitals, same energy with the same spin. The first thing is what? You get symmetrical arrangement. One thing is what? Symmetrical arrangement. Remember, always symmetry leads to the stability. One reason. Then here, all the 5 electrons are spinning in same direction. That is 5 into plus half. What is that? 5 by 2. 5 by 2 is 2.5. The spin of 5 electrons, when it is multiplied, what you get? 2.5. The 2.5 is spin multiplicity is maximum. When you get 2.5, when you arrange the all the electrons in the same direction, which is known as Hund's rule of maximum spin multiplicity, which always produces high stability. So if I write one of the electrons as opposite spin, what happens? The first is plus half. The plus is first is plus half, second is minus half. So these two get cancelled. Then what do you get here? 3 unpaired electrons spinning in same direction. So in this case, now what happens? 3 into 1 by 2. And 3 by 2 is what? 1.5. So which is more spin multiplicity? 2.5. When all the 5 electrons are spinning in same direction, the spin multiplicity is maximum 2.5. But when you fill the electrons in same energy, degenerated with opposite spin, the spin multiplicity decreases. Then stability decreases. This is according to Hund's rule. Then one more is, see here all of you. The one more is, after symmetry, the simple answer one can give what? Half filled configuration. Because this all, see with all of you, this all orbitals, five orbitals are filled with one valence electron. Very good. Then we can say it is what? Half filled. Then half filled may have opposite spin or same spin. But which is having more stability? Same spin is more stability. Okay. So here, one thing remember. One more reason is exchange energy. Exchange energy. Now all of you see here. When you have five unpaired electron, when you write 3D4, in D sublevel, four unpaired electrons are there. Okay. But when you write 3D5, five unpaired electron. As number of unpaired electrons increases, one thing happens that. See, you might have learned or heard about transition elements. Everyone knows blue color is known as copper sulfate blue color. Some compounds are color. The transition element compounds are color in nature. Why? Because any D block element having the at least one unpaired electron, one single electron in D sublevel, they absorb the visible light from the nature and show complementary color, opposite color. Thus they exhibit a color property. So here, now when you have unpaired electrons, they absorb energy from the visible light and these electrons exchange their positions. So now if you take this first electron, this electron will exchange its position with the other four. So 1, 2, 3, vice versa. Four combinations. Next, when you take this electron, second electron, this will already this is interchange with first one. So next, 1, 2, 3. Where previous is already completed. Three exchanges. Next, if you take this one, third electron, this will be with next one. Two combinations. Next here, this fourth electron show with fifth electron. So how many? 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. Then how many combinations? 10 combinations. Okay, 10 times the electron will get exchanged with each other. And when they are exchanging their positions, they absorb certain energy, they exhibit color. And not only that, from themselves also, from electron also, the energy which is N plus L, some energy is used by energy. Okay. So for exchange of position, they use some energy. And during this exchange of position, they lose. Okay. They undergo loss of energy. And when energy gets lost, stability increases. So to calculate this, you can use NCR rule, combinations. And one more formula is, that is for exchange energy, there is a formula delta E. I'm writing here delta E exchange energy is equals to N. N is, that is number of combinations into K. K is a unit, where N is given as N into N minus 1 by 2. K is unit for energy. So what is this N? Number of unpaired electrons. So if N equal to 5. So what is this? N equal to 5 means you get delta E is equals to, I'm putting in formula, N into N minus 1 by K. Energy comes in by 2. Energy comes in K. So what is this one? Now unpaired electrons, how many? 5. So 5 into 5 minus 1, N minus 1, 4, 4 by 2, K. So what is this? 5 fours are 20. 20 by 2, this is 10K. So 10K is energy and 10K is nothing but number of exchanges. Okay? And in the same way, if you write for 3d4. If you write 4s2 and 3d4 for chromium, then in that case you get 6k. So 10k energy is used more. When energy is more used for the exchange of positions, stability increases. Stability increases in case of 5 electrons. And when, if you write 4 unpaired electrons in 3d4, then what happens? 4 into 4 minus 1 is 3. 4 by 4 into 3 by 2k. So 4, 3 is a 12. 12 by 2, 6. So which is more energy used? 10k. In case of 3d5. So according to Hund's rule, it gets stability due to maximum spin multiplicity, and one more is more the unpaired electrons, more is the exchange energy, more is the loss of energy, therefore stability increases. In the same way, we'll go for the copper. I'll change here. In place of R, U. See, U cuprum. Copper, cuprum Latin name. Atomic number is 29. Up to the argon is 18. So, what is this one now? You must fill first 4s with 2 electrons. And so, 18 plus 2, 20. How many left beta? 9. So, what we expect? 3d9. But what happens? Violation of rule. Auberg principle is violated. So, one electron from 4s shifted to 3d becomes 3d10 and 4s1. Without completing the electrons in the low energy 4s, the electrons are completely filled in 3d. Violation of Auberg principle. But here, what happened? Though doesn't have half filled configuration, exchange of positions, but completely filled is always stable. Completely filled is always stable. So the copper shows stability, abnormal configuration because of completely filled 3D. Completely filled 3D10 configuration. So this is what abnormal electronic configuration. Abnormal electronic configuration to get stability. Okay, and remember all of you, you must write 3D before the 4S. Give me thumbs up. Because 3D is present in third orbit, 4S in the fourth orbit. So when you come from the nucleus of the atom to outside, so you first meet first orbit, second orbit, next third orbit, and fourth orbit. In third orbit, you find 3D. In fourth orbit, you find a 4s. So the correct electronic configuration must be written as 3d first, 4s later. Okay. And next, one more thing. As I told, transition elements means d block elements. Okay, 3d1 to 3d9. Remember, 3d1 to 3d9. 3d1 to 3d9. It is scandium to copper. Third level. Okay, like that fourth series. These elements forms color compounds. Color compounds. The reason for color compounds, color of compounds is unpaired electrons. So, to calculate the color of the these transition elements, the d block elements are their compounds which contain at least one unpaired electron, there's a formula to calculate their color, and they all act as magnets also. Everyone knows iron is magnetic in nature. Because of this reason only, it is getting attracted to magnet. Always likes. So the train and railway tracks are made up of iron only. So when they are continuous rupture in contact, they turn into true magnets, permanent magnets. So iron is Fe. Iron is magnet. So what is the reason behind the magnetic property? Unpaired electrons. Any d block element or any compound which contain at least one unpaired electron, they behave as a magnets. So for magnetic property, there is a formula to calculate magnetic nature. So see, this is mu, magnetic moment, is equals to root over n into n plus 2. The value comes in Bohr magnetons.